going to demonstrate with Ken the third Ken Suburi and with my in-depth tutorial to assist you get an improved third Ken Suburi, if you like. So I'm going to demonstrate first and then give you as much advice and help from my knowledge to you. So. Okay, so the third Ken Suburi is more like a breathing exercise. So when the Ken goes up, you breathe in from your nose, you bring the air down. When the Ken goes down, you breathe out, and you breathe in. Breathe, exhale, up, and breathe out when you cut. That's, I think, one aspect of it. The other possibility is you breathe in when the sword goes up. You hold your breath when it goes down. And you breathe out when it goes up. So there's two possibilities. I think you can train with both. I tend to do the first one more, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. But the second one, when you hold your breath, it's a bit deeper and you really feel the explosion when you do the cut. So I'm going to demonstrate when you breathe in, breathe out, and when you breathe in, hold the breath and cut and breathe out. When you hold your breath and you raise the Ken, I have a feeling that the ki eye will be a bit more louder. So now I hold my breath. Both are fine. There are a few things that we need to work on. Is with the third Ken Suburi, it's very much the feeling of Morotirogi, Ryotirogi, and Shinage. This feeling. And Shinage. So, there. This feeling. We go back with a Ken. So, is get this feeling. So you don't actually raise the cane on its own. It's from here. There. You stay down. The cane is up. Up. Stretch of your spine. Up. Your face doesn't move, but your body does. Settle. Cock you. Feel as if someone is holding your cane at the end and is preventing you from moving. So it's not raising the cane and then up. It's more hips, that feeling. And that's the feeling. But you don't want to be in that position because it exposes all your organs. So when you get to this feeling, is you actually thinking of cutting already before you step forward. So you get this feeling. As opposed to this feeling. And that's another feeling about the Ken Suburi. Same with the Joe Suburi. There shouldn't be a pause between one movement and another. It's got to be interlinked together. So, demonstrate. This is continuous. Tanto. If you haven't got a garden or space, especially when you raise the cane up, tanto is good for this. So there, cane come on. The footwork, precise, now it's a bit square here because you raise the cane up, as you drop the cane, it's again into him. Yeah. Whichever front foot is forward. General rule is you lock it before you step forward. There. Lock it. As you collect, you lift. And do this before you do that. And this so valuable information, because it's the same if you're going to strike, you don't indicate what you're going to do. Don't do this. So kick. You lock it and you kick straight from here, from the other, or straight into that, or straight into You come in. Start short to the tempo on the side of the neck. More of a tempo actually. But it's always keeping the footwork minimal. So go down. Same. You bow. That music. And keep footwork minimal.